Welcome to March Madness Minute number 18. Today we're going to continue to look at Google Classroom and specifically how to leave different types of comments and grade work. So one thing that's really nice about Google Classroom is you don't need to wait for students to turn their work in to see it. You can see their work as they're creating it live. And while they're working, you can leave notes, little post-it note type comments, and suggestive edits. So while they're working on their assignment, you're helping them and doing more of a wellness check than waiting till the whole assignment's done and turning it in, which is a little more like the autopsy report. So we will look at when they do submit their work, how to grade it and leave comments, and we'll also look at what's happening on the Google Drive side of things. So I'm going to go to classroom.google.com, and I'm going to the classroom that we created yesterday. So one of the assignments was called Pick Your Colony. And I can see I have zero students that have turned it in, one that has turned it in. So I'm going to click on the not done, and I would see all those students that haven't turned it in. I can click on their name and then click on the work. So once again, this is not a turned in assignment. This is something that they're just working on, and I can peek and see what's been done so far. And I can even see the student is in their document right now, and I can see where their cursor is. So if I wanted to go through here and leave some comments, longer life, I'm going to highlight this, right click, and leave a comment. And when I say comment, now it's a little post-it note type on the side, and if I click on the highlight, my post-it note pops up. And vice versa, if I click on the post-it, the highlighter gets a little brighter. And that's really nice if you have multiple comments on one document. So if I leave a comment here, now I can see the relationship. So those are comments. And if I pop over to the student side, they can see those comments as well. And on the student side, I could just say resolve to get rid of the comment. I could reply to the teacher right here. Or I might just say how much longer I might resolve it and leave that information in my paper and just kind of weave that in. And if either the student or the teacher hits comments, they're going to see all the comments pop back up even if they hit resolve. So I'm going to pop back over to the teacher side. So once again, the student's still working. And I can leave something called a suggestive edit. And this is like track changes if you've used that in Word. So I'm going to go to suggesting. And now it's in green. And let's see. So if I suggested deleting something, it's not going to actually delete. It's going to put the strike through. If I add some detail somewhere, it's not actually adding it, it's adding it with these colors around it. And if I go to the student side, on their side, my icon is pink, so they are using pink here. And I can see my suggestion was to delete something, and they could say, you know what, I really don't want to delete it, so I'm gonna reject the suggestion, and my information went away. If they thought this was really good information to add, they could say, oh, sure, and hit the check mark, and now that suggestion is added. So we've looked at post-it note type comments and suggestive edits. So let's say the student is now ready to turn their work in. Once they hit this turn in button, they won't be able to make any changes on their work. So let's say turn in. And I could leave a comment for my teacher here and turn it in. Now let's say I forgot to do something or I remembered something else I really wanted to add in there. I can say unsubmit, make those changes, and resubmit, and my teacher will see that it's been unsubmitted. So I'm going to go back to my work here, pick your colony, and I'm going to look at the work that's done. And when I look at the completed work, I have this option for grading. So I've already read the student's work. I'm going to look at points. And let's say I was using a 4-point rubric and I just wanted to have 4 points. I can type that in and hit enter. And now I can leave points. I'll say 3 out of 4. And if I click on the student's name, now I can see a link to their work, I can see their comments, and I can add comments here. And post it. Now if I have all of my students here, I've graded everybody's work, I can hit download and this assignment, and I'll get an Excel spreadsheet with the students' names and the number of points they received. I could then upload that document into Skyward as their assignment grade. Now, one thing that's really important to notice, so students have turned their work into me, so that means I'm now the owner. For them to see their grade and to see any of the comments, I need to hit return. When I hit return, final draft due next week, I can leave a comment, and now the ownership is going back to the student so that if this was a rough draft, they can make changes and resubmit. I can go back to the student side, and now the student sees their grade and those comments. Final draft due next week. So the last piece I wanted to show you was in Google Drive. As soon as you create a classroom in Google Classroom, you get a classroom folder that automatically pops up. When you make a classroom, it's going to then make another folder for your classroom. And every time you make an assignment, it's making a folder. So let's see, I had a Pick Your Colony piece of assignment. And all my students' assignments are automatically going in that folder. So if you prefer to pop in your students' work this way, that's an option for you. You can see everybody's work at once instead of clicking in and out of people's names. And that's also true on the student side, is in Classroom, the students in Period 1 March Madness, and when they click on it, they see all of their work. So I hope that helps with leaving comments, suggestive edits, and grades. And then what's happening on the Google Drive side. And tomorrow we'll look at how to add multiple grades for an assignment using a rubric.